Like and subscribe in the next 5 seconds if you want this XP glitch to happen to you in your next game of Fortnite. Fortnite Chapter 2 Season 4 released just over a week ago now, and with that said, with the release of every new season anyways, everybody's wanting to grind out all the rewards they're entitled to earn, whether in the free section of the Battle Pass, and believe me, there's a lot of rewards here that we can earn for free on screen, all of which in Season 4 are contained right now, or from simply having the Battle Pass, whether gifted to them or buying it themselves. Either way, most people will have the same end goal of leveling up to level 100 to not only earn all the free rewards that go up to this threshold, but the Iron Man skin if owning the paid version, and let's just say with the release of Season 4, obviously there's a ton of XP methods we can combine together, with a fresh start or reset to the season on our Fortnite account in terms of level, or with new XP earning methods introduced. And in terms of leveling up, with everybody being on the same page, wanting to achieve the highest level possible until the season ends on November 30th, currently set on the Battle Pass, I'm going to be showing you guys a ton of not only individual XP earning methods, but ones you can combine together to not only achieve level 100, unlocking Iron Man and then the suit up emote from obviously going over to Stark's warehouse, but this will also be your best shot at achieving as close to level 1000 as possible, and believe me, you're going to want to now, considering we can earn some crazy secret selectable styles or rewards for skins throughout the Battle Pass at these higher levels that we're going to be discussing in just a second before we start with the XP methods, so make sure you're sticking around and watching the full thing. And speaking of the Battle Pass in itself, if you happen to pick it up, gift it to somebody else, or get anything from the item shop, slap code FriendTheMachine in there, as this directly supports the channel, and a channel of which is one of very few on YouTube right now that still tries to meet this 5 daily gift limit by rewarding their most loyal of subscribers every day. So if you potentially want to be shown on screen gifted in the future videos to come, or even the next one, make sure you're subscribing to the channel right now and comment your Epic Games ID down below, so perhaps, like I mentioned, even in the next video, I can get around to sending you your very own cosmetic or battle pass. Even if you don't want to receive a gift, make sure to subscribe now regardless, as 70% of all eyes on screen, yes you, I see ya, make sure to click the big red button, turn it to grey, and whilst you're at it, allow all notifications to come through, as we're rapidly approaching 1.9 million subscribers, and we'll be there in no time, or even 2 million if everybody supports on today's video. And with all that out the way now, the first thing we need to go over or show you guys in terms of what level you at least need to be to unlock everything eligible to earn this season is the foil styles. These initially start at level 105 with the silver version of Thor, obviously after maxing out the battle pass in terms of the rewards we can see to earn anyways, and go up to level 140 in terms of only just this colour, as then they progress into gold styles, additional not turning from silver into gold, at level 145 for Thor firstly, and go all the way up to level 180 in terms of unlocking the final gold style being for Wolverine. Not only that, but Fortnite have then gone a step further, and at level 180 we can earn the first rainbow holo foil style for Thor, and goes all the way up to level 220 in terms of unlocking this secret rainbow holo foil style for Wolverine, our secret integrated or battle pass collaborative skin this season. In terms of the amount of XP you'll need to earn to get to level 100 in itself, this will require from level 1, starting out a new account, 7,570,000 XP, but in terms of earning the max holo foil style being the rainbow Wolverine, this will require from level 1, 15,309,000 XP, being a difference of 7,739,000 XP between level 100 then and 220, the additional 120 levels that we don't see displayed rewards for on the Battle Pass menu itself. And with that said, that might be quite off-putting in terms of them being substantially high numbers or amounts of XP we can earn, considering, well, each elimination is around 100 without supercharged XP, but there's a lot of things you guys can do exterior to just getting eliminations in a normal game or Team Rumble, which is the recommended game mode regardless, such as, if we look on the menu, not only the quick challenges, the first set of 5 anyways rewarding us with 50,000 XP with each 24-hour period that passes, if we were to complete the first 5 quick challenges rewarding us with 50k every day from August 27th, the start date of Chapter 2 Season 4, until November 30th, the end, this would give us a whopping 4,750,000 XP, however I highly doubt any normal human being could make that definite commitment for all 95 days in a row. So on top of that then, if we head over to our map challenges, or the weekly challenges now called on this menu, we have a total of 7 challenges, 6 of which reward us individually with 25,000 XP, which are fairly easy, but one more difficult one with a recommended amount of players despite just yourself, usually being 4, that grants us 50,000 XP for completing completing this one challenge. With this applying to every week, this kind of structure or amount of XP we can earn from weekly challenges, this allows us to earn 200,000 XP per week, and as you know, there's 10 sets of weekly challenges that release in every season, even if the season gets extended without any additional or any less, meaning that 10 times 200,000 is 2 million. And if we combine that with the 4,750,000 XP that we earn from completing the quick time challenges, the first 5 anyways for all 95 days of this season's duration, we're at 6,750,000 XP earned already, nearly meeting enough to become level 100 from simply buying the battle pass at level 1. On top of these two types of challenges nearly getting us to level 100 in themselves for simply completing what's available every day or every week anyways, we have the punch cards. For each stamp on a punch card anyways, varying dependent on what the punch card revolves around, we get 15,000 XP. Some punch cards may be just singular for reaching level 100, for instance, like this, or may go all the way up to having 6 whole stamps we can progress through. However, obviously these are only for the people who grind the game in this particular aspect the most, as the challenges get harder the more stamps you earn on an individual punch card. It's safe to say, regardless of whether you're completing your quick challenges, your weekly challenges, or anything on the punch cards you can see, it's best to be playing Team Rumble as previously mentioned, not only because of the fact you don't have to worry about being eliminated permanently from the game by simply going in a non-respawn game mode, as Team Rumble allows us to respawn, which everybody will be aware of, and because of that fact too, upon doing the challenges, you may come across people also doing the same thing, and upon picking up weapons, you'll be able to pick up more eliminations than a standard game, this way as opposed to going in a solos, duos, or squads. On top of this, another reason for why Team Rumble is great for earning XP despite just the challenges you can complete and eliminations along the way, even if you're playing normal, is for collecting the XP coins, and obviously we have a brand new set or whole new locations this season reset from Chapter 2 Season 3, of which can easily be navigated or found in location form pinpointed on the minimap itself when opening it up across social media, or you can simply go over to fortnite.gg, which I'll link in the video description down below, and this is very useful for your personal use, despite obviously showing all the locations of each individual XP coin, as after you earn one or collect one, you can mark it off on the map so you make sure or ensure you don't visit the same location twice, wasting that game time where you perhaps could either be getting more eliminations, completing another challenge, or picking up that other additional XP coin that you're still needing. Not only from picking up all these coins, granting us XP in themselves, will we earn XP, but simultaneously alongside picking all of them up or venturing through this journey every week when new ones are released in terms of their locations, will earn additional stamps along the way of doing this on our medal punch card for picking up certain coloured XP coins in themselves, rewarding us again 15,000 XP per time or stamp that we collect. The only downside to playing Team Rumble is this will not allow you to earn the punch cards for either reviving your teammate or actually rebooting them from the reboot vans. And speaking of rebooting people, the best way you can utilize this is have one teammate down themselves and then obviously die out, instead of multiple up to 3 at a time and then picking up all the reboot cards, as this will only count for one stamp or point on your punch card progression. You also won't be able to shake down any of the henchmen surrounding these Quinjet sites anyways, as they won't appear, and obviously then meaning the Stark crates aren't flying above, which again do reward us punch card points, and then we won't be able to use mythic weapons that we get from these supply drops, nor get Doctor Doom's arcane gauntlets, or the other big ball, because of the fact these again don't appear in Team Rumble. Despite these being downsides, and there being only just a few more that I'm not going to bother to mention, considering they're very minute, Team Rumble is the way to go, not just because of all the reasons and positives I've already mentioned, but because there's some XP looting methods that you can use, considering you do respawn or the strain on you surviving is a lot less, but you don't even need to be good at the game, so let's hop into a game and show how you guys can do that and rinse or repeat it every game you go in right now. Okay, so let's suit up and actually get into a game and explain this live. Okay, so upon loading into a game of Team Rumble, you'll see the central reservation lines dividing two teams anyways, your team and the enemies, and what you want to do is land at somewhere, obviously that you don't particularly think maybe looted that often or many people will go there, but at the same time has a ton of things to loot in terms of ammo boxes, chests, and also even perhaps at the orchard, like what's located on the outskirts of Frenzy Farm. vegetables. As you can see, this dude's probably already doing it. He's gathering a ton, or inspecting, should I say. And before he steals all these over here, I'm going to show you guys how much XP you can earn real quick just from literally inspecting vegetables and then leaving the game and doing this again and again and again. So we're already up to 720 XP, and that's literally normal XP, not supercharged, which is like 5 times. So I would have got like 5k XP there nearly. And just for an example, I'm not going to loot the entire area and bore you guys to death, but basically once you're done with one area, if you don't land near the circle, particularly in Team Rumble, the best thing is you can either glide to where you want to go, or you can simply eliminate yourself by building a ramp with the materials you've got spawning in to spawn at the circle, another location where you can pick up these supply drops that spawn in, or you can go to another named location. Perhaps Risky Reels is quite good considering there's a lot of chests or lootable options there in close proximity. So from making our way down to Risky Reels, as you can see, there's 3 chests already that we can actually loot that haven't been touched for whatever reason, considering it's in the circle. There's even ones behind me in that little hut right there, but as you can see, there's one, so that's 130 XP, or around 500, 600 if we had supercharged. Then we have this second one right here, and obviously along the way from going around carefully anyways, you'll spot not only more chests in this location anyways, but ammo boxes, and they give you pretty much the same amount of XP as you'll be able to see as a chest. From doing this around one particular name location, people have been able to get literally up to level 500 per season from doing this hours on end per day, but if you guys just want to grind out for a few hours and perhaps get up some levels without having to sweat it out, this is definitely the way to go, especially if you're not that brilliant at the game. And to be honest, I'm no pro. Again, you may get lucky and the circle may fall on you with the supply drop spawning, and that's exactly what we can do, open supply drops that spawn here, or perhaps are landing. If you're lucky enough by getting good loot out of the supply drops too, this will set you up for the entire game despite you messing around at the start, also just gathering items such as consumables or opening chests simply for XP. Typically in Team Rumble, people tend to flock to one particular area. I mean, if the authority's in the circle, you best believe that everybody's landing there. So for that reason, on the outskirts, obviously before they make their way in to have this huge battle, which is going to look like twice as big as this in terms of the tower that's built from all the building structures, we can just go around the outside and, yeah, open these supply drops, open whatever chests are left over, considering not everybody will have got them all. If you want to stay in the game, you can, but I'm just going to leave right now, considering, I mean, I'm just showing you guys this for the purpose of the video, but you could stick around till the end, get the win, get a little bit more XP, or get eliminations in terms of that extra XP, but you don't have to, and obviously the more you loot, the better, so I recommend backing out and starting this process over and over again if you're serious about leveling up fast. But with that said, time to take the suit off, time to end off today's video, so if you enjoyed, don't forget to slap a like in it down below, as then you'll be able to refer back to all the methods, if you perhaps forget any, in your liked video playlist, as it will then be saved there. And whilst you're doing that, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, considering 70% of you still watching even at the end of the video for whatever reason aren't subscribed. And also, whilst you're at it, turn on all notifications so that you then never miss any future useful uploads just like this one. Hopefully I can then recognise you, remaining active in the comment section of the future videos to come, and I'm out. So have an amazing rest of your day or night, wherever you are, whenever you're watching. Have a good one, take it easy, and as always, peace.